Hey, Battle Bill, here with another video, getting into some more Season 8 Go Battle League battles, and today we have another submission from a fellow PvPer of the community, and we have quite the spice content for y'all taking place in the Master League. The homie Keto submitted another set of battles for us to enjoy, using SmackDown Shiny Tyranitar, and with all the flyers around, this might not actually be the craziest spice pick in the world. It might just work beautifully. So if you're excited to watch this team comp together with Lugia, Zekrom also, which is not exactly commonly used Pokemon in Master League battles, and Tyranitar with SmackDown in the back, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And let's just jump right into these videos. Keto, thank you as always for the spice content that you be submitting to the Battle Bill channel. We also just recently hit 7K, so thank y'all so much for that. It really means a lot to me. Let's continue getting this YouTube content out. So Lugia on Dragon Lead, they save swapped into Giratina Altered. And you know what Pokemon is going to line up well with Giratina Altered? Tyranitar. Now with Bite, it would have lined up even better, but with SmackDown, it's in a pretty solid situation considering it resists all the ghost damage, and then the Dragon Claws are only neutral and they don't hit hard. Crunch is going to hit hard, gets the Giratina Altered's first shield, waiting to see if they decide to throw another charge move they're going for. It's only a Dragon Claw though. Tyranitar is not worried about the first couple Dragon Claws. It could still take another one. Easy clap. He gets a whole SmackDown through as they go for another Dragon Claw. Still not shielding because not worried about potentially getting Shadow Claw down either. And going to go for another Crunch. Now his opponent decides to double shield in a terrible situation with their Giratina Altered lined up with the Tyranitar. They decide not to. Tyranitar definitely walls ghosts pretty well. They come in with the Palkia to Dragon Breath down. Definitely a mistake by the opponent even committing a shield in that situation. But the Lugia comes in and lines up beautifully against the Palkia. And now a Landorus comes in. That is not the Therian. That is the Incarnate form with Earth Power and Rock Slide. Yes, I don't understand why I'm struggling so hard to recognize it. We do need to watch out for a Rock Slide that's going to come through. Yes, there it is. I'm correct. Sun Edge definitely would have hit a lot harder from the Therian form if it was that we're going up against, but ends up just being the Incarnate form. Throws two Rock Slides. Lugia's like, I tanked that easy. Obviously did not want to swap in Zekrom here for two reasons, because Landorus is that ground type, plus Zekrom is going to do beautifully against the Palkia since it's an electric dragon going up against a water dragon. Now they're both taking super effective damage from the dragon moves. Palkia goes for the home run because Keto had two shields and the Draco does not land. Keto calls it, opponent top left. That was their only play. There was no way they were double baiting Aqua Tails and then getting to the Draco in order to, and surviving that long to try to pull off the match. Getting into the next one, we got Lugia on another Palkia lead. I haven't been seeing as many Palkias, but hey, we take it. They safe swapped Heatran here. He's staying in with the Lugia. Honestly, probably wants to go for Tyranitar pretty quickly. The SmackDowns would be neutral because of Heatran's steel typing. But ends up swapping into the Zekrom. Okay, understandable play here. Definitely can't completely argue with it. The crunches are going to hit. The Dragon Breaths are still going to add up, even though they're resisted. Heatran and Masters, I feel like I haven't seen that since Season 1, 2. But then again, I haven't been playing Masters since like Season 1, 2. Iron Head comes through. I guess maybe that's what he was worried about, because Tyranitar would take super effective from the Iron Head. But Fire Spin doesn't exactly generate energy that well. Goes for the Wild Charge, lands it, Dragon Breaths down the remaining health, and then their opponent brings in an Excadrill going for the Crunch. The opponent's definitely going to go for a Mud Shot down at the Zekrom, so the Excadrill is going to be loaded on energy. Will he be able to pull this one off? Decides to pivot, does not want to get farmed down, swaps back into his Lugia, but then they come back in with a Palkia, which was in a losing matchup to begin with. So let's see how the rest of this match is going to turn out. Keto seems to be sitting pretty well. Aqua Tail comes through. Was worried about a potential Draco there. This is definitely another Aqua Tail. Not going to get shield baited twice. Looks like he wants to commit to a complete Dragon Tail down of the Palkia. And that is a great play because Lugia is so tanky. It's not worried about the neutral Dragon Tails coming from the Palkia when Lugia is dealing super effective ones back at it. Going for a double Sky Attack. Gets the trainer's last remaining shield and goes for another Sky Attack here, which is going to take out the Excadrill. Really well played by Keto. Didn't even need Tyranitar, because obviously Tyranitar's presence is what hard carried that match. You'll love to see it. It's almost looking like deja vu of our Carvana video from the last one. Getting to this next match, we have Lugia on a Lugia lead, and Keto's Lugia is a little bit lower in CP, 3685 against 3695. So it doesn't look like he's going to be winning CMPs unless they have the same attack stat, which is still possible. Then it's a flip of the coin on who's going to win CMP in this situation. But the opponent throws a sky attack right away. Keto's deciding to go for the arrow blast. It is going straight arrow blast, the play in this situation. Let's find out how this turns out. Arrow blast lands, attack buff. I mean, when you land the arrow blast and if you get an attack buff, definitely seems like the play to me. Unfortunately, didn't get the attack boost there. Opponent goes for another sky attack, and clearly the arrow blast has done more damage in this situation. And Keto's at another sky attack. It looks like he almost wanted to commit to a dragon tail farm down. Gonna shield another sky attack that comes through. Does he commit to the dragon tail farm down? That is quite the play. He has two sky attacks built up. Definitely wants to get them off back to back, depending on whatever they swap in. Oh, over taps. But is able to, I guess, survive a Thundershock because Lugia is such a tank. And then, unfortunately, doesn't get off the other Sky Attack. I guess he was hoping he had enough energy for a Sky Attack and an Arrow Blast. And he then gets Thundershock down. Comes in with the Zekrom. Definitely needs Zekrom here. Do not want to be bringing in T-Tar against a Melmetal where Melmetal can throw a superpower that would be double super effective because of Tyranitar's Dark and Rock typing. But Keto's not looking like he's in a great situation here. Melmetal had shield advantage. There are even shields now. Melmetal's throwing another charge move. Question is, what is the opponent's last Pokemon? And will Zekrom be able to get rid of this Melmetal so that Tyranitar doesn't have to worry about getting superpowered? Another charge move coming through. Should be another Rock Slide. Zekrom will barely survive. Thankfully, those Thunder Shocks are double resisted because of Zekrom's electric dragon typing. So holds on to get off another crunch. Will the opponent commit the shield? They decide not to. Does not want to get farmed down. Swaps into the T-Tar. Has to shield this. Has to shield this. I got nervous. He wasn't gonna shield there. That superpower is still gonna do a lot of damage. And their last Pokemon is a Giratina Origin. So it looks like T-Tar is going to actually clutch when you're using Tyranitar. This is definitely what you want to line it up with. All the ghost types you could possibly find, all the Giratina Origins and Altereds, anywhere they're gonna be, you want your Tyranitar there. Even if you do not have Bite, because Smackdown's doing good neutral damage, and as long as the Giratina is not running Dragon Pulse, specifically the Origin, because Giratina Altered only runs Dragon Claw, and we saw how that matchup played out. As long as they're not running Dragon Pulse, Tyranitar can sit pretty, as you saw it tank that Shadow Ball. Easy clap, gets off the crunch here, should take out the Giratina's remaining health, and wins in this match. So honestly, something that wasn't looking too great. He pulls it off really well. Thankfully, they didn't commit to the Melmetal there, but that's an understandable non-commit, because you don't know the Tyranitar is there, so they wanted to obviously play it out. Play out the neutral matchups and keep even shielding. Getting into the next matchup, we have Lugia on a Groudon lead, and this Groudon is running Mudshot. Honestly, I'm thinking Dragon Tail Groudon is new meta because it really helps Groudon in its losing matchups like this one here. The Dragon Tails at least do neutral damage, and as much as Groudon still loses to Lugia because of Lugia's tankiness, it at least can put in some work in, like, you know, the Dragon Tails adding up and then the Fire Punch is being neutral. But Groudon doesn't want to stay in this no matter what, but with Mudshot, it's even worse for the Groudon. And then they save swap a Giratina Origin in, throws the Arrow Blast to get the shield, and then comes in with T-Tar to absolutely wall another Giratina Origin. So it makes the opponent top left. There we go. Title made. Tyranitar making Giratina Origins top left in Master League battles. Keto has definitely been lining up his Tyranitar beautifully for these set of battles, and you love to see the spice having success. Get into the fifth and final match, because we only have one set. When it's this spicy, I'm thankful that the people that submit me battles get me at least one set to at least see the crazy spice in action. And Tyranitar has definitely been pulling some moves and pulling some punches, getting some very positive situations. And now, because of the lead, the opponent save swap Kyogre, and he matches that Kyogre with Zekrom. Zekrom going off, putting in some work, resisting, double resisting all of Kyogre's waterfalls because the electric dragon typing, lands a wild charge, takes out the remaining health of the Kyogre, but unfortunately debuffs the defense and is not going to be able to get to another charge move when the Dialga comes back in. He goes back in with the Lugia. Charge move going to come through. I don't think it's going to be a Draco. He decides not to shield. It was not a Draco. It was a Thunder, though. And that Thunder is actually huge. Will Keto get off both Sky Attacks here? Hopefully no sneaky no sneaky Dragon Breath to get through while he tries a double Sky Attack. Gets the shield. This will not take out the remaining health, but will do some nice chip damage. A little bit of chip damage. Not nice. Swaps into T-Tar. And now we have T-Tar on Mewtwo. Has to worry about getting Focus Blasted. No! I was like, with two shields up, Tyranitar was looking so good. He just wanted to call a bait so that he had the essential third shield, because Psy Strike would have been double resisted. But the opponent goes for all the marbles and is able to pull the dub, and T-Tar was not able to two shield flex clutch the match there because the opponent made such a crazy play. That poor Tyranitar going up against a Mewtwo with the double super effective focus blast, a one shot. The Kyogre was taken out. Honestly, if he calls that focus blast there, he just wins because he probably could have farmed down by smacking down the Mewtwo and would have had a 5-0 set with Tyranitar in some Master League battles. But the opponent goes for all the marbles and it pays off. Sometimes in the two shield situation, you just got to be like, honestly, I'm going to lose. What do I have to lose? Just going for the big move right here. And it was able to steal that match from Kido. Either way, though, that set was a lot of fun to commentate, and Tyranitar put in some work, obviously, got all the potential positive matchups that you could hope for a Tyranitar to get, and overall, the battles were enjoyable, so I hope you enjoyed watching the Spice content. Tyranitar, Master League, quite the Spice pick. Kido, thank you so much for the submission, as always. Also, I forgot to say this in the beginning, y'all should know by now though, because Kido has submitted plenty of content to the Battle Bill channel. The link to his Twitch is in the description. If you want to continue to see Kido do these battles live, hit the follow on his Twitch. I highly recommend it. It would mean a lot to me also. So please, link is in the description for Kido. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe on the YouTube channel too, because like I casually mentioned earlier, we hit 7K. I was sitting at 6.9K for quite a bit of time. Me taking my little hiatus has not done me any favors on YouTube, but we're just getting the content though, and I hope you're enjoying watching it, because honestly, at the end of the day, whoever this gets to, I just want to make sure you're having a positive experience with my content. So as always, thank you all for watching, and I will see you all in the next video.